It is my great pleasure to introduce our next presenter. He's an author and Academy Award winner who reinvented the documentary. Sincerely, this man changed the way I view the world. Thanks to his work, I am now, as the kids would say, fully woke. From Flint, Michigan, please help me welcome Mr. Michael Moore.
Thank you. Kim Kardashian stole my speech. I'm excited to be here tonight to present the award for online film and video breakout of the year. And I'm happy to say that it's not that video of Donald Trump killing a kitten. Making movies is not easy. It's hard work and it takes a lot of time. Sometimes it takes a few years for me to finish a film, but that's nothing compared to the commitment of the two filmmakers who produced the Netflix true crime series called Making a Murderer. Moira Demos and Laura Ricciardi met at Columbia University's film school a decade ago. One day they read a news story, and with no financing and no plan, they chased it all the way to Manitowoc County, Wisconsin. They spent the next 10 years crafting the story of an alleged murderer, Stephen Avery. That's 10 years. Like the serial podcast that came before them, they tapped into people's insatiable desire to discover the truth. And it helps sometimes when that truth is entertaining. Last December, Making a Murderer became a binge-worthy runaway hit that consumed many of our winter vacations. When you're in Flint, you don't really winter anywhere. And thank you for bringing up Flint, Nick, and I hope that people here don't forget Flint, because things are not well there. But it established Moira and Laura as two passionate new voices in filmmaking, something we need very much these days, especially when our film industry still last year, when 2% of the films released by Hollywood were directed by women. 2%. If you want to know why the movies mostly suck, it's because the same old stories are just being recycled by the minority gender. And I think the movies would be a lot more interesting if the other 51% of the population got to tell some other stories. So that happened in this case with these two young women, and we're all the better for it, for this fascinating documentary. And thanks to those institutions, these new institutions like Netflix, that actually will put up the money and stick with a crazy idea like this. We're lucky that things have shifted and that the middleman and the studio and the people that have controlled this for so long, they're gone in many ways, and we can talk to each other on this great invention of the last century.
Do we have a body or anything yet?
I don't believe so.
We have Stephen Avery in custody, though.
Are you kidding me?
The disappearance of Teresa Halbach remains a mystery.
Mr. Avery's blood is found inside of Teresa Halbach's vehicle.
Hey, everybody's listening. What do you want to say today?
I'm innocent.
If convicted, Stephen Avery will spend the rest of his life in prison.
We found a key.
That key was scrubbed and his DNA was placed on it.
This is really strange.
What's going on here?
Halbach's last stop Monday was at Stephen Avery's home.
If he did this, maybe it was good he was in prison all that time.
everything I've heard him say hasn't been the truth.
It was extraordinarily disturbing.
We went through this 20 years ago, and we're going through it now again.
In this criminal justice system, good luck.
You are probably the most dangerous individual ever to set foot in this courtroom.
The truth always comes out.
Well, when I am president, I will do two things, I promise you. At award shows, we'll go back to showing actual clips instead of advertisements and trailers. And the other thing I will do is one charge cord for all devices. One cord. 100 years ago, big government, two prongs, every cord, right? Still the same, two holes in the wall. 100 years later, fucking new cord for every new fucking device. I got cords. Fucking. Stop it! Please welcome the winners of the Online Film and Video Breakout of the Year Award, Moira Demos and Laura Ricciardi.
The story is not over.